welcome, damas in here, and okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the month of March. I'm back in camera, so a lot of you will see. All right, so let's get in the month of March, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see what is coming up. What I'm getting for the month of March is like a new beginning. It's really spring that is coming up, okay? I want to say thank you to all my out subscribers. Thank you so much for returning. The month of March has the energy of, it's a new break, it's a new beginning. We are all here and we're all going to be seeing what is happening and transpiring. So let's see what is the first energy that is coming out. We have a situation with a corporation institution. Okay, so when we think about corporation institution, we're thinking about love, Venus, we're thinking about group of people, and there is some sort of a deceptive play. Okay, the energy of a devil. So there is some sort of a deceptive play that is going to be coming up in a corporation institution where some of you have to decipher what to do, but you're going to be victoriously overcoming this, okay? You're definitely going to be victoriously overcoming this. It was a situation that was happening in the month of February. You come in the month of March, overcoming the situation, and light is now shed on some sort of a unfavorable situation that was happening in a corporation institution, and some of you could recognize it and see what was played, what was transpiring, and is trying to resolve a situation. So it's not really a dull month. I wouldn't call it a dull month. I will call it a month of you understanding that there are some sort of unconventional situation. It could be in governments, institutes, organization, but it's as if you something happened in the end of February coming in, and what transpired is that you are going to be overcoming this. So it could be a situation at the workplace, and light has been shed as to what has been happening and what has been transpiring. Then this is a beautiful card. This is a lucky card that is going to be coming up in the first week. A very, very, very lucky card. This is the luck of the deck. That means that a lot of you that works in corporation institution, big corporation institution, people are going to be recognizing that there was some sort of foul play that was happening and transpiring. Then I see judgment is going to be coming out, but it's going to be very positive. It's going to be something coming out. So it could be something around government, institutes, your organization. That is going to be coming out, and that is going to be spreading light as to what was transpiring. Then we see the energy of the Empress, and the energy of the Empress is coming up, where it could be a mother figure that was in the hospital, or your grandmother, or that sort of a thing that was in the hospital. But it can also be a bank financial institution where there was some sort of a fraud or dishonest play. It is now coming up, and this is going to be good. So here you have the energy of success. As I said, it was really positive information is going to be coming out. Yes, 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 because here you have the energy of success. Beside judgment, that means some sort of a positive news is going to be coming out, letting you know that you overcome whatever the problem, the issue, and the situation that was transpiring. Then we see in the third week, you're overcoming some sort of a hardship, some sort of an unsavorable situation that was happening and transpiring. You had to put on and find inner strength in order to recognize what was happening in a corporation institution, and taking the bull with the horn in order to resolve a situation, okay? The energy of the lover is here, so I see some of you, a new contract could be coming in for some of you. This is good. Some of you that was having issues, marriage issues, marital issues. This is also going to be coming out very good. You have only positive energies that is coming up. Then we recognize the energy of the Emperor. So a lot of you are going to be finding out things about people in power. People in power, people who have used their powers in the wrong way. A lot of you, a lot of information is going to be coming out, and it's going to be showing up some sort of a false play that was happening to people and how other people use their powers in order to accelerate a situation and change a situation. And this is definitely going to be coming out. Then we see the last energy that you're going to be dealing with in the month of March. It is going to be the energy of temperance. And this is Mercury. Okay, temperance is bringing back balance and with communication. So this is going to be a very, very, very significant month for a lot of you. It's going to be a month when you're opening up to certain sort of energies that is going to be transpiring and is going to be coming out for a lot of you, okay? So I find this to be a really, really powerful month. It's going to be a month where there is a month of a sweet, sweet states, and I call them the sweet states month. It's going to be a month of rest and rejuvenation. So this is going to be good. It's going to be about a lot of you just connecting with yourself. Okay, so this is like the energy of you resting out a period, a situation, some sort of a situation that was occurring. You're resting out this period. Then we see the woman holding the heart. And this is going to be absolutely wonderful because number 19 is the energy of the sun, and it's about connecting. Okay, number 19 is really about connecting because it's about 1 and 9 is 10. So what happens is that a new start, a new beginning, and that is what the universe is offering to a whole lot of you. The woman with the heart is a beautiful card, and it's a beautiful card because whoever this person is, have a very, very positive, open heart. So you could be dealing with someone, whoever this person is, whatever is transpiring, you're going to be dealing with a woman who has a heart of gold, a woman that recognizes what it is to love and how it is to love. And you're going to be dealing with someone like this. Okay, so this is going to be an extremely, extremely powerful month. So it is a really exuberating month because we also have wishes and dreams coming true. Okay, wishes come true, dreams fulfill, magnificent time. So I love to always open the springtime with the energy of the fairies. I mean, they're one of my favorite deck, and this is by Doreen Virtue. And what she's doing and what she's bringing up is that she is coming in. It's like the Venus. It's as if love is the mother of love, but yet still exuberating you. The Nine of Cups is always about Jupiter in water, water in Jupiter, Jupiter in water. And this is a very, very positive energy to have this, okay? And then we see the energy of Wheel of Fortune. So a lot of you, a lot of fortunate situation is going to be happening and transpiring because it's as if the universe is going to be coming in and it's going to be really balancing out a lot of you in order to help you to recognize what you need to look at and how you need to create your own world. Okay, and this is going to be good. So let's first go in and see what is coming up in these four weeks. We have 4 weeks, okay? And with these 4 weeks, what is happening and transpiring with these 4 weeks is that we are recognizing that it is going to be a month where a lot of you are dealing with some sort of an unconventional situation, okay? So it was some sort of a situation what you were dealing with a corporation institution. And whatever that was happening in this corporation institution, it could be your work or it could be government, it could be financial institution, whatever that you were doing and whatever that was happening, a lucky break is going to be coming in. And when we talk about a lucky break, it's a, when we have a lucky break coming in, it's because the universe wants to shift some sort of an energy that has been happening and transpiring. And with the energy of judgment and the fountain and the sun, that means it's going to be absolutely, absolutely brilliant, okay? So we have these three energies that we're cornered with, and the two first week is going to be very, very positive. It's not a bad month. A lot of you are going to be dealing with issues with your mom. I see here issues with your mom, but you're going to be resolving this. Some of you could be helping your mom to get out of some sort of an unconventional situation that was transpiring. The energy of the fountain is as if some sort of a universal source of energy is going to be coming in and helping some of you with a situation to move forward and overcome some sort of a problem with an institute, organization, or someone who have used their powers over you and your partner. You're going to be very, very successful. And this is like marriage situation. Whoever that was having marriage problem, marriage issue, marriage situation, it is going to be very, very good. Then we see the energy of judgment. I'm going to take the energy of judgment. And the energy of judgment is reminding us it's not about tragedy is going to be happening. It is about transition that is going to be taking place. So where we're going to be really recognizing that we can make changes in our lives, okay? So it is a positive alignment of energy. However you look at it, we're recognizing that whatever that was happening in the corporation, some sort of a truth is going to be coming in. And this truth is going to be giving a lot of you a push going forward, okay? Because whatever secrets that was hidden, it is going to be coming out. So we have 4 weeks. We have the first week earth, the second week fire, the third week fire, and the last week we have water. So it's like your balance coming in the month of March, but as you move out of the month of March, you're leaving some sort of information behind and shedding light on a situation in order to clear up and make changes in some sort of a corporational situation and problems that was going on. So it could be at your workplace, it could be with banks, financial institution, that sort of a situation. When we talk about corporation and the elephant, it is always about huge group, a corporation, international, but yet still mundane, because what is happening and transpiring is that it has to do with a large group of people where you could be going in looking for help, that sort of a situation, okay? So what we're going to be looking at is the weeks. And when we look at the first week, we have the hurt with the fountain. So it's as if Mother Hurt, the universe, is intervening in creating some sort of a positive balance. So, you know, we have been going through this issue, this problem with the virus and that sort of a thing. And now it's as if in the month of March, what is going to be transpiring is that you're going to be exhilarating where you know, more of this issue, situation, problems is going to be resolved, and it is going to be resolving in a very, very positive way. Then we see a corporation institution. Some of you, your parents could be having some issues that you're trying to resolve with this corporation institution. I see this as family members. I see you women together with your kids or your partners is trying to resolve some sort of an issue, okay? So what we're seeing is that whenever these two together with the sun, is that whatever problems, whatever issue that was with people and their families, whatever problem that was transpiring, especially married couple with a contract or some sort of a contract that was not properly done, you know, waiting to hear if your contract is going to be extended and that sort of a thing, it is going to be a yes. So that is going to be absolutely, absolutely fabulous. So I see a lot of you women could be reconciliating with your partner, and this is going to be absolutely good. You're definitely coming in trying to reconciliate with your partner, trying to recognize some sort of an issue, whether with the ex, whether with your husband, whether with your wife, a family member, a brother, a sister. This is all about resolving situation with family members. So, you know, there could be some issues like you know, your parents passed away, you're trying to resolve and dealing with certain situation. That is what is going to be coming up and transpiring. So we recognize that. As we go into third week, it's a fire week. The second week is not going to be, you got to watch out. Okay, whoever you are, you got to watch out in the second week. The second week, we have the energy of the fountain and the devil. And the energy of the fountain and the devil is basically the universe is coming in and is just saying, hey, you know, this situation needs to be balanced out. Whatever is happening in this situation, it needs to be balanced out, okay? I see a lot of you are finding inner strength to balance out this situation. And if you notice, it's as if unexpected help is going to be coming in the second week for you guys to balance out a situation, okay? It's all about balance, okay? It is all about balance. So we see the universe really stepping in order to help a situation. We have the energy of temperance, we have the energy of strength, okay? So we have fire and hurt, and it's as if the hurt will win over the fire no matter what it is, because no matter how you can blaze with a situation with where fire is coming up, but the hurt always win over the fire. So what we're recognizing here is that the universe is coming in and said, hey, this situation needs to be resolved, and a lot of you are going to be finding the inner strength to resolve it and bring a situation to a balance and let it go. Okay, it's as if you gotta resolve whatever this issue is. And when you look at these two energies, temperance and strength, it's about finding and going within and recognize that you have your own demons within. Okay, we have the ego. This is the energy of the ego. So it is going to be a very egotic week where a lot of people should step back, okay? Just calm down in the second week, because it's going to be a week where a whole lot that is happening and transpiring, and a whole lot of you are going to be trying to push through, but you will have the help from source in order to do this. You will definitely have the help of source in order to do this and in order to resolve whatever that was happening and transpiring. So this is going to be like some sort of a lucky break that is going to be coming up in the second week, okay? When we look at the parents, mothers that was having health issue and that sort of a thing, the reconstruction of people are going to be recognizing, hey, this health issue, this situation can be resolved in another way, okay? And I see a lot of you ladies that was having a whole lot of health issue problems with family member. You are going to be balanced, okay? And you're going to be resolving the situation in a very powerful way, because we have also the Empress and the Sun. So there is a whole lot of things that is going on with your materialistic stability, where there was a sort of a negative energy that was trying to control a situation where you have now removed this control, and it's letting people know and it's advising other people about some sort of a control issue that people are trying to use in order to create some sort of a issue, situation, and you're going to be like showing it up and saying, hey, this is what it is. And you know, you have to be alert, ladies and gentlemen, of what is happening around you. So I see it's a situation where a lot of people are going to be speaking up and letting people know what was happening, what was transpiring, really speaking up and letting people know that there was some sort of an undesirable play that was going on in a corporation institution. When we go to the third week, another really, really fire week. This is good. This is about moving forward. It's no victory and success. It is a fire week. It is about movement. It's about really moving forward. And this is going to be a very good week for women. Okay. Women, business people, entrepreneurs. It's going to be a very good week. Some sort of a positive news is going to be coming in the third week, offering you some sort of a promotion. Okay. So women, the third week is as if, and I see this coming up in the last years. I haven't been on camera, but the third week is going to be you moving forward, especially entrepreneur business. If your business was a little bit blocked, that sort of a situation, you're going to be moving forward in such a powerful way, overcoming the obstacles that was created. It is going to be a really powerful week. It's like a sweet week for women. Okay. This third week for women is going to be very, very, very positive. Okay. So we have you moving forward. Some of you might be offered some sort of a management position because they're going to be recognizing that some of you have been kept down for a very long time, and your skills and expertise is very good, and you recognize and see things that other people were not seeing, and bring it to some sort of a balance. And I see that they're going to be recognizing how powerful you are, recognizing and seeing the flaws in some in corporation institution, recognizing that there can be changes. So moving forward is in this week, and a lot of you that was having issues with relationship, family member, this is going to be resolved, okay? Because you're going to be overcoming these obstacles. This week is about overcoming issues, problem, obstacles that was going on. Some of you were fighting to resolve some sort of a situation with your mom, with your wife. So it is as if issues is coming up for men with their mom and with their wives, but you will overcome this and recognize and resolve the situation. So a lot of men are going to be having some sort of an issue with female, okay? But you will overcome this. But if this female is a family member, so it could be a wife, sister, daughter, that sort of a thing, but you will overcome this. So that is the flip side for men. And a lot of people do not recognize sometimes what is happening and transpiring. And sometimes I will start and so much information comes up as we move forward. I don't read cards. I channel. So the information will come out for the people who needs to receive the message. Okay. So it's a powerful week. The third week is about moving forward, moving forward. It's about releasing things and showing up things that has been happening and transpiring. So I really, really love this month for you. So women, some sort of unexpected situation is going to be coming up, because it's as if you women, it's as if transition, because the female energy is coming back. And the female energy is coming in with Venus. You have Venus in the middle of this month. Venus, and that energy of Venus with the judgment, which is like that is a Uranus energy, is like the Pluto energy, pulling, removing. You think about Uranus and Pluto together, with strength, Uranus and Pluto, like removing obstacles, situation that was created, and bringing back some sort of a powerful balance. And that is going to be good. So, you know, coming out of this month, you're going to be feeling the shift, but it is going to be a shift in a very positive way. Then we see the last energy on this week, the Hermit. And the Hermit is always about showing up something. And this Hermit is looking the way it is set, it is showing up or some sort of a movement, travel situation that was happening. So this can be something with the virus, the movement of things that is happening, how the transition is moving, and it has to do with a corporation institution. So you got to be aware and recognize where the issues and the problems is. And it's showing up something about travel. And whatever is coming up, it's as if travel was really blocked. And you can see this. It's a shedding light where a lot of you didn't have free movement. And it is going to be resolved in this month. So if you had some sort of a blockages, you couldn't move for free, you had some sort of a health issue, you have to wait on people to take you around, that sort of a thing. You know, it is going to be resolved, and you're going to be finding a way to resolve this, because the energy of the sun is here, and it's just going to be absolutely wonderful and beautiful. And this is a really, really positive energy. It's about light has been shedding on some sort of an unconventional situation, something that you were, that was an obstacle, something that was a career for you to block you moving forward. And light is going to be shedding, and you're going to be recognizing that you're going to be finding the inner strength and come out on top with the energy of the sun, really coming out on top with the energy of the sun, and recognizing the obstacles is going to be moving away. It's as if sometimes we ourselves create obstacles in our mind. And then all of a sudden, in the fourth week, some sort of a light is going to be coming in, shedding on how to remove these obstacles in your world. Then we see some sort of an issue with your boss could be coming up, or someone who has used their powers in the wrong way. Okay, so this is the Emperor and Balance. This is whenever the Emperor and Balance comes up, it's about people try to conventionally use their powers in the wrong way in order to throw you off balance, and you recognize what was playing. Okay, so sometimes people can just give you wrong information or faulty information because they know they have the power to do it. And I think that these you know, people who does this sort of a thing is just mentally off balance. Okay, because why would you just, you know, step out of your way in order to give some sort of a dishonest information? That is not normal. So that means that the person is a mentally incapable of being honest to themselves. So they create other problems. So I see it could be someone who has used their powers. I see they, you know, people found out what this person have done and what this person have created. And what they're now doing is to resolve a situation because they recognize that someone has used their powers. So it is a powerful, powerful month. You know, this is so powerful because you're seeing the shift and all of these shifts. But whenever the sun comes up together with the lover that is in your foundation, it is very good because you and your partner, you and your marriage, you and your relationship, whatever that was transpiring with a relationship with your husband, with your parents, whatever that was transpiring is definitely going to be resolved. So some sort of a news is going to be coming in. If a lot of you had problems with family member, that sort of a thing, some sort of a positive news is going to be coming in order to say, hey, you know, we're trying to help you to resolve a situation and to bring a situation to light and help you to overcome whatever family issues there was. So I want to go back to this because a lot of you ladies is going to be finding new love in this month. It's as if the universe is going to be recognizing that, you know, your heart is so powerful, and your heart, you want to relieve your heart chakras in order to give you powers to love again. So a lot of you women are going to be feeling as if, oh my God, it's as if a burden has lifted. The pain I had with my relationships, these are now over because I am releasing myself and I'm feeling good releasing myself. I am understanding who I am. And it's as if I am feeling joy returning in my soul. And this is going to be absolutely, absolutely positive. There is no question. A lot of women that was going through heartbreaks and pain, it's as if a shift of energy is going to be coming in your heart chakra and helping you to really, you know, clearing up the heart chakra space, and it is going to be absolutely wonderful. So this is another blessings that is going to be coming in. We have the number 44. This is about powerful. This is about the ascendance masters and angels and guides. It's coming in to help a lot of women to feel the awakening of the heart chakra. Okay, it is really a feminine mantra. We have two feminine energy. We have the energy of the heart. The hurt women are going to be feeling this month, and the fire women. It's about earth and fire. That is going to be feeling the movement that is coming up in this month, and it's going to be absolutely, absolutely fantastic. So it is a month where we are going to be really evaluating a lot of things in our lives, especially women. And it is a feminine month, ladies and gentlemen. I can't change that. A lot of you men will be feeling your feminine energies coming up. That is something I can't change. And what we're seeing is that women are going to be healing whatever problems that you have with men that was using their powers over you. You're definitely going to be changing the shape of energy and balancing that out in order to recognize what was transpiring. So I see this is good. Now, in all four corners, you have earth, water, and hurt. It's about the hurt and water. And they're really facing each other. And when we say facing each other, is that you have the hurt and water. And in the middle, we have fire. So if you do the opposite of earth and water, and that's why hurt people and water people are so good, because they have some sort of a balance, okay? And it's all about hurt and water, and everything that is coming in is about another, the judgment and temperance, okay? So some sort of information is going to be coming in the first week that is going to be helping you to balance out whatever that was happening and transpiring, recognizing whatever that was coming up and transpiring, okay, giving you balance to a situation, to a family issue, to a marriage issue, to some sort of a work contract. This is also a month where a lot of you women could be pushed up the ladder, where you're getting like management jobs and position. I see the universe is going to be coming in and removing some sort of an unconditional play that was transpiring and breaking it down. And a lot of you are going to be finding the strength to stand up to some sort of an equality and injustice. And you're going to be coming out really successful, because it's as if you saw some equality and injustice of some sort of a play that was happening and transpiring in a corporation institution. And you're definitely going to be overcoming this and receive what it is that you want, taking back what it is that should have been yours, and people were trying to work against you in order to take this from you. So this is going to be very, very good. A lot of you women are really using this energy in this month. We have the earth people and the fire people. So hurt people, think about the second week where you're going to be fighting with some sort of an unconventional situation that was transpiring in a corporation institution. And fire people, think about the third week where there was some sort of a problem, issues with contracts or with a marriage or with a relationship that you're going to be overcoming. And this is good. The fourth week, it has to do with work, people in power, people in government institutes, organization, where light is going to be shed, where information is going to be exposed. So expect in the last week of March, some sort of information is going to be exposed, or people was using their powers in the wrong way in order to get things done for themselves. And people are going to be recognizing that. So it is powerful. Taurus, you're in the first week. You're going to be feeling this energy in the first week. A lot of happiness is coming in this month for a lot of people. It's as if it's a sweet seed. It's as if spring is coming up and a whole lot of happiness is going to be coming in. And this is going to be so positive for a lot of you, because this happiness and transition is going to be here. That is bringing a whole lot of you a whole lot of balance. Women, and this is a powerful month for you women. It is also the month of the women that is coming up in the second week. The 8th of March is International Women's Day. So that is going to be very, very good. So celebrate the 8th of March, ladies and gentlemen, especially women, because it is the International Women's Day. A lot of you women need to celebrate because you have come through such a hard time with this COVID in 2020. Then we are looking at luck. Luck is here for the Tauruses in the first week, Tauruses and Scorpions. Whatever is happening, Tauruses and Scorpions, you have luck in the first week. We also have the Taurus women and Cancer and Gemini are going to be having an effect in the first week. The second week, we have the energy of, oh my God, the Aries. And some of you dealing with Aries, okay? The fire sign people are going to be having it a little bit hard in the second week and the third week, okay? So we see the Aries having it very hard in the second week, the Leo in the third week, okay? The Empress is the energy of Taurus and Capricorns, Virgos. I see some sort of a successful situation for you guys, okay, in the second week. A lot of you hurt side people were fighting with some sort of a difficult corporation institution. You're going to be overcoming this and be successful in the second week. The third week, fire sign people are going to be having it out with the Geminis and the Libran. Whatever is happening and transpiring, I see fire sign people really having it out going forward with the Geminis and the Cancers. So you're going to be having some sort of a collapsing, committing, however that is. So then in the 4 weeks, I see the Pisces and the Scorpion. Pisces, Scorpions, and the Aries with the Gemini. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpion, Aries with the Gemini, okay? Now, it is a very significant month for a lot of people, because there was some sort of an unconventional change that was transpiring. I see a contract, whoever was dealing with your husband or someone who have used their powers in a wrong way, you're going to be overcoming this, okay? Or some sort of an issue with your child, your husband, your wife, family members, you're going to be overcoming this and bringing a balance. So you're ending this month. This is the sign of Virgo, okay? And this energy of Virgo have Mercury, communication, true communication. A lot of you are going to be resolving some sort of issues, problems that you were having and that was transpiring, okay? All right, so this is going to be good. It is a mixture, a month of mixture, no extreme except the energy of the devil, where a lot of you are going to be overcoming this situation because it has to do with your materialistic stability. Like people were lying and trying to get away with a whole lot of money, and that is going to be showing up, okay? Let's see the other message for the first week. I see some sort of an ending is coming in to some sort of a negative energy that was happening with the energy of the devil. A real negative energy that was transpiring is going to come to an end. You're going to be moving away from this. Light has been shed on some sort of a false play that was transpiring. So that is going to be good. Then we see a transition for people who were power playing. There was people who were using their powers in the wrong way against some of you. It is going to be ending. It could be also a boss. They're going to be firing a boss at your workplace. Transition is coming up, but it's going to be positive transition because you have the energy of judgment, the sun, with the levers and balancing out the situation with a relationship. And it is going to be creating a lot of changes in your world. So this month is about ending issues, problem, situation, unconventional situation that people were creating around you. And by, you know, really going in, recognizing and, you know, showing up, whatever that was unfair, whatever that was dishonest and unfair, you're going to be ending some sort of a power struggle and to be taking back your powers in a wonderful way. So, ladies and gentlemen, I do love this for you guys. It is going to be an absolutely fabulous month. You gotta come back and always listen to the generals. Always listen to the generals because sometimes there are information that is coming out. The generals are very good because they help you to understand what to expect in the month. Go and listen to your sun sign and your moon sign. Okay, that is very good. Sun sign, moon sign. Cross watch and see what is happening with your partners, your friend, people who you connect with, sisters, brothers, in order for you to know what is coming up for them. So you can advise them as what is coming up. These readings are timeless. So whether or not you pick it up in the month of March, whenever you pick them up, they're all timeless. I do love you guys. Please show your love by thumbs up and use that button as subscribe. I do love you. Namaste. Until next month.